Alright, I'm here today to play with a few new toys, one of which is this 8-bit dough M30. It's a wireless gamepad for the Sega Genesis. It comes with this little adapter that plugs right in to an old school Genesis, which is pretty awesome, if you can see right here. I've got the old school Genesis plugged in right now, and I'm using this pound HD link cable for Sega Genesis. Just got it yesterday, and it came out within the past couple weeks here, end of June, I think. So I want to play a couple games and see how it goes. All right. Let's turn this guy on. And I think I just hit a button on the controller here. Hit the start button. Looks like it's got a little blue light saying it's connected. So that's awesome. Make sure everything else is nice and snug. Looks like it might not have turned on properly. Anything? Nothing. All right. Yeah, the Genesis is pretty old, so. There we go. All right. I'm going to play one of my favorite games. Michael Jackson's Moonwalker. I hope to one day start a series where I try to get the world record for a speed run with Moonwalker. But that'll be forthcoming, if indeed it does happen. Glad your headphones are muted, Jen. One of the first things I gotta do when I start the speedrun is learn the places where the children are. I usually just try to hit every door in the level. Yep, there we go. The other thing is, I know a lot of people use the A button more because it allows you to move and attack, but I usually saved all of that because I wanted to do the dances at the end of the... Oh, that's not what I meant to do. glad you feel triggered, Jen. This is not a Michael Jackson defense channel, in case anybody's worried about that. There we go. Yeah, I should take up more of that square. That's a good idea. I'll adjust that in a second. Why not? Let's do it. There we go. How's the mic to game sound, John? Am I loud? Should the game be louder? Michael. All right, cool. Let's adjust this a little bit. That's good. Alright. So here's where I lose a lot of time on my speedrun because I don't know where the children all are. I will say the image is a little bit jittery through this HDMI cable, but overall, it looks pretty great, and it's great to have a way to play genuine Genesis hardware on a new TV now. Yeah, bullets don't move that slow in real life, in case anybody wanted to know. I'm not noticing any latency. Like, honestly, this wireless controller feels like literally no input lag, which, I mean, Maybe if I was playing a fighting game or something a little more intensive, I might notice it a little bit more, but I doubt it. Like, it feels pretty perfect, which is crazy to me, but awesome that they can make, like, a new controller that, that works with old hardware and works perfectly at that. Oh, God. There we go. I know roughly where most of the children are. I didn't try to kick... Well, you have to... Sometimes you have to kick... This. No, I'm not going to say it. I'm not going to say it, John. I try to kick everybody in this game. Because you got to save the children, John. If they're keeping Michael from saving the children, they have to get kicked. This game is really dumb at, like... I just made that old man blow up. This game is really dumb at, like, spawning in enemies whenever it feels like it. Like, right below me here? Yeah. It's not concerned with being fair. I don't know if there are any more of them down here. Yep. Okay, that's good. I'm gonna assume I checked everybody on floor 2. Oh. Whoops. Don't even say it, John. Yeah. There's probably a cat in here. Nope, there's a woman. That's good. A child. Excuse me. There's a cat in here for sure. Yep. There we go. Got him. Yeah, the jitteriness that I'm speaking of is has more to do with the I don't think I went left here, did I? All the way. The jitteriness is more about the just the way you see the image kind of judder up and down a little bit. Something that probably wouldn't have been noticed on a CRT just because it's not as sharp of an image on a CRT. It's a lot softer. So, not really a problem. I think it's just an artifact of taking something that's not HD and putting it on a very clear screen. Alright. I hate these guys. They suck. I think the frames dropping has to do with... That's just the way it looked. The way the animation works when he gets hurt. Or when he finds a child. There we go. Time for the streets. Outside of Club 30. There's a bomb there. That's not good. Yep. Probably another bomb. Yep. There's a dog. Yeah, the world of Moonwalkers, this really kind of horrifying dystopia. I don't know if anybody's written any scholarly literature about that or not, but... Come here, dog.
Michael.
don't know. There's one more somewhere. It's not in there. These damn dogs. Did I check the doors? There we go. Let's go do the beat it dance. Oh. I want to be up on the wall. Oh, it's going to make me go down. Okay. If you walk at Mr. Big, you get hurt, so you don't want to do that. Yeah, there we go. It's a good music video scene right there. God, this game's so dumb, but it's perfect in every way. So good. Alright, let's just go straight up to... No, because I should just fall off the side in order to get on top of the building. Oh no, this is just the... God. Of course. The 16-bit versions of Michael songs are very good. See, here's the thing. I check all these cars and get hurt a lot because of it. If I knew where all the kids were immediately, I wouldn't get hurt. There's probably not one in the next one over. Of course, there's a bomb there. There's probably two on the top. Nope. Alright, I gotta save my health here. Gotta be smart about this. Alright, have fun with Destiny, Jen. That's a bomb. There we go. And now they send the dudes with assault rifles after Michael Jackson for trying to find all the kids. It's not a super challenging game. I mean, I have some trouble with it later on, because I'm not that great at video games, but... Not sure why there's a child in the sewer, but there is. Let's do some moonwalking. Of course. That's cheap. Pretty sure there's not one in there. Michael. Alright, so this is actually the first, like, difficult boss fight, kind of. If you don't kill the dog. I think he appears in the upper right, though. Oh, no. There we go. That wasn't that hard. Yeah, for some reason in the American version of the game, it's a rights issue, I believe. They do not have Thriller playing in the graveyard level, which is the biggest oversight in the world. But they play Another Part of Me, which is also a good song, but it's, let's face it, it's not Thriller. For some reason, there's parrots that are in the graveyard. You're just another part of me. But they do the Thriller dance. It's just to Another Part of Me. For some reason. Because of a rights issue. See, this is the Thriller dance, for sure. There's no Another Part of Me dance that I know about. There might be, actually, but I don't know about it. Michael. That's pretty good. 97 seconds. Yeah, so this is where the levels start getting more complicated in scope. Although, I guess in the beginning, the club levels... Oh! I missed the comment to turn him into Mecha Michael. Metal Mecha Mega Michael. Yeah, I'm not gonna hit that parrot from here. I think there's probably another one right down here. Nope. I think I'm wrong. I can't be wrong, though. Realize how powerful that hat was, because I never used it, so I was too afraid to use my life. Because the magic from Michael's fingertips is mostly powered by his life force as well. Alright, I'm just gonna go to the top. Or not. I'm gonna get screwed here. Oh, I don't have any magic left. I died. Alright. I'm mostly just testing this out, so let's try another good Genesis video game. I do have the original box and manual complete in box. Box is in bad shape. I should probably swap it out for a better one, because this game deserves better, but it's the best. This is one we used to rent all the time, and I ordered it on eBay probably in the year of 2013 or so. Also one of my favorites on the Genesis. Sadly, neither of these are on the Genesis Mini, but there is a good lineup for the Genesis Mini. Nope. Let's try again. Probably gonna need to replace that connector for the... cartridges. Nothing. It's not good. Oh no. Why don't you want to work anymore? There we go. Maybe I just wasn't giving it enough time. Good old EA. No microtransactions in this one. But it is a classic, in my opinion. Haunting, starring Poltergeist. I would love a remake of this game. So basically, you're the scary guy, Poltergeist, the green dude, and you possess items in this family's home to try and get them to leave the home. So if I press start, you can kind of see the layout of the house and where each of the family members are. So let's go get Mimi out first. Do some crazy stuff with the molding there. And, how about this coat rack? See, the worst part about this game is what happens when you run out of the green ectoplasm bar. Her fear level's high now. It's pretty good. This game's pretty genius. Alright, so she's gonna run out. Every time you get them to leave a room, they drop ecto for you to replenish with. She's in a room that has an exit to it. So, if I play my cards right, she's gonna leave. No, don't go there. Just leave. Oh. Alright. We'll follow her. She's still in here. Some fireworks for 4th of July for you there. Why are you going that way? I want you to leave. She just peed her pants. She's not giving me much to work with, though. Oh, she's gone. Nice. Alright, I don't have much ecto left, so gonna have to go and yeah, there's some frights where you can chase the people with them to get them real freaked out. If I press A, yeah, it just flips out like that. Oh, his fright level's only low. But Vito's a man's man, so, you know, he's never gonna be scared. They do call it Ecto, that's good. So this underworld sucks. There's these, like, traps that try to catch you. And, the more you get hit down here, like, this is your actual finite life. That little picture in the bottom left starts shrinking, which means that your time in the underworld is limited. Like, you cannot even, if you're sent back here, you can't replenish your life. Like, when that depletes, you're done. That's a game over. Which is, it's kind of a, like, it's a very weird system. But, you know, it's the start of video games, I guess. I don't know how they want to do it. Sweet rock song there that he gets to dance to. Alright. Full bar. Let's screw with Vito some more here. Got a rat in the garbage can. There we go. Pretty good. Raise the level a little bit. Well, let's pop into the water heater. Maybe it'll just make it break, and then that's the scariest thing that could happen with your water heater. Yeah, that'll do it. Oh, he left. Alright, so we'll pick up the Ecto. Follow him. Looks like he's still in the hallway at the moment. Did he leave though? Nope. He's getting ready to leave because he's so terrified. Let's see if we can get him to leave right here. I feel like it's pretty close. Yeah, he's gone. Suck it, Vito. Alright, let's try and get Tony out. Wrong room. No, I can go through here. And then he's in this bottom one. Alright. He's already at a very high fear level. Follow. Where did he go? He's in the living room. the old lava on the floor trick. You know? Couch has spikes in it. Pretty creepy haunt there. And he's out. See if we can finish this house without getting any more. Where'd you go, Tony? Where is he? Oh, he's just chilling at the door already. Alright. Send some wasps after him. Oh yeah, his head just exploded, so that's good. And he's out. Peace out, Vito. Or Tony, excuse me. Alright, and then Flo is the matriarch of the family. Let's go see what she's up to. Some good haunts in the kitchen. Spaceship that comes out of the cupboard for some reason. Some good sound effects. I just exploded her right out of the door, apparently. Alright. She's in the office. Dropped your skirt, that's good. Blood stain on the floor. This game's great. She's terrified. Yeah, let's go. Got lots of ecto. Plenty. Let's see what comes out of these drawers. Some rats, kind of. Some, I don't know what that was supposed to be. Alright, she's gone. Hopefully one last room here. The old cannonballs on the love seat sofa thing. Chair. Is she gone? Oh, she's leaving. Yeah, boy. Yeah, I've never finished this game. It's always the same family. They just move to new houses each time. Not sure what the red is meant to be. Yeah, and the other mechanic is if you don't collect the ecto in time, there's less of it. More traps to it each time, too. Which makes sense. I think I should have a full bar this time around, probably. And they changed the layout a little bit too. Alright, where we got? Got Mimi in here. Alright, let's go for Mimi. I think the dog screws with you somehow. I forgot about the dog. She's flipping out. Alright. So she's in this hallway. The old moose and the dartboard. Hate it when that happens. Out of the toy chest seat, pretty good. She just keeps going back and forth. Couch turns into blood. Mimi's a tough customer. Oh, that dude appears sometimes too. Alien in the mirror. Yeah, unfortunately, no exit in the bathroom, so probably not gonna get it this go around. But yeah, the houses get bigger and more complex. I think more interference for you appears in the form of like the dog and that dude with the green head. Just keeps coming back to here, man. Center of the house will never scare away, so. Alright. I think that's enough of Haunting starring Poltergeist. Thank you everybody for watching. Just want to do a quick little test of this equipment. Yeah, so far I would say I'm extremely impressed by this 8-bit DOE M30 controller. Virtually no input lag that I could notice in these games, at least. It's got the nice 6-button layout, which is obviously the preferable one. It's got these L and R buttons, which I don't know if this can also be used like a Saturn, maybe? I'm not sure. I'll have to look into it, but very impressed with this purchase so far. I think I got it for 20-something, maybe $30 on Amazon. Very good. And, yeah, the Pound Technologies HD Link cable for Sega Genesis. It works with all three models of the Genesis, which is very cool. I got it. We have a Genesis. Our original Genesis here that I'm using is a version 1. It's the first generation of it. And that one often needs a little more hookup just to kind of explain what's going on here. So, yeah, that just cut out, but you got this little box, and it's got the HDMI there, and a little USB port here, where it gets powered. You can plug that into any kind of USB port. It's just plugged into one on my monitor right now. And then this cable here fits into a Genesis 2 or 3, I believe, but the Genesis 1 has this extra cable. All this is included in one kit. So you plug this guy in here, and then this guy goes into this port on the Genesis. So overall, works great. Not much in terms of setup. Like I said, comes with all this, comes with the USB cable to charge this guy, comes with the HDMI as well. So that's all very cool. But yeah, overall great product. Again, maybe $30 on Amazon. So if you're looking to play your Genesis on an HDTV or, you know, stream using some original vintage hardware like I just did, pretty easy solutions available to do that. And yeah, this controller is great. I have no qualms about this. It feels it doesn't quite have the same glossy finish as the original Genesis controller, but it works fantastic. 35 hours worth of charge on one charge, so that's great too. And yeah, it's fantastic. I'm excited to use it some more and hopefully start my Michael Jackson's Moonwalker speed running show, so keep an eye out for that soon. But thanks everybody for watching, and yeah, let me know if you have any questions in the comments on this video, or tweet at us, MGN Podcast on Twitter. If you like what you see here, go to mpn.bz/Patreon and donate to our Patreon, and make sure you check out our podcast, the Midwest Game Nerds Podcast, available on all podcatchers. So thanks for watching, and see you next time.